हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ मिस रचना जैन, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश, गवर्नमेंट पीजी कॉलेज, राजगढ़, अलवर। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू द कंक्लूडिंग पार्ट ऑफ द पोयम शैल आई कंपेयर दी। दिस इज माई फोर्थ वीडियो लेक्चर ऑन दिस पोयम। This poem is in the syllabus of BA Part 1st, English Literature, Paper 1st, Unit A. First of all, I read the four lines of this stanza for you. But thy eternal summer shall not fade, nor lose possession of that fair thou wast. Nor shall death break thou wanderest in his shade, when in eternal lines to time thou growest. Now I explain you the difficult words mentioned in the poem in simple English words. The eternal summer means the permanent youth and beauty of the poet's friend W.H. Fade means disappear. Lose possession means gets lost or is deprived of. That fair means beauty, intellectual or spiritual beauty. Waste means which the poet's friend has or possesses. Brag means boast or proud. In his shade means in the shadow of death. Eternal lines means the beauty of the poet's friend becoming eternal and permanent. To time means for future times. Thou growest means the beauty of his friend does not decay but grows permanently for the future times to come. This stanza has been taken from the poem Shall I Compare Thee, composed by William Shakespeare. Shakespeare in this sonnet is addressed to his friend and patron W.H. The beauty of his friend has been immortalized in this poem. In the previous stanzas, the poet has said that the beauty of summer's day and the flowers of May end after some time. They are short-lived. But it is not so with his friend's spiritual and intellectual beauty. The poet says, "Thy eternal summer shall not fade." The poet means to say that the spiritual and intellectual beauty of poet's friend will never fade away. It is immortal. It is permanent and everlasting. It will neither fade away nor decline. Nor lose possession of that fair thou wast. The beauty which his friend has will never lose its charm. It always shines brightly and will also shine brightly in future. Nor shall death break thou wandering in its shade. द पोएट पर्सनिफाइज डेथ हियर. ही सेज दैट ऑल्दो डेथ हैज ऑलवेज हैड एन अपर हैंड ओवर लाइफ, इट डिस्ट्रॉयज एवरीथिंग. Nothing can escape from the jaws of death, but the beauty of his friend shall never be destroyed by the death. Death never touch the spiritual and intellectual beauty of poet's friend. The reason is that wherein eternal lines to time thou growest, and the reason is that that poet has depicted the intellectual and spiritual beauty of his friend in the immortal lines of his poem. So the beauty of his friend will live in this poem through eternity. Death will never be able to lay hands on his friend's beauty, as his friend is immortal. The poet means to say that his friend is portrayed in the eternal verses, so even death will not have any effect on it. His friend's beauty will become a part of the immortal poem of the poet and will live forever. This is the couplet of two lines which is always in the poem of Shakespeare. So long as man can breathe or eyes can see, so long lives this, and this gives life to thee. Man can breathe means man continue to live in this world. Eyes can see means men and women see with their eyes or read the poem of the poet. Lives this means the beauty and youth of poet's friend will last, or this means the poem. The poet says that his friend's spiritual and intellectual beauty is portrayed in the eternal verses, so even death will not have any effect on it. His friend's beauty will become a part of the immortal verses of the poet and will live forever. So long as man breath and they live on this world and they have the power to see and read, till then his friend's spiritual and intellectual beauty will live, because the poet has depicted the beauty of his friend in the immortal lines of his poem. So long this poem is read by the people of coming generation, they also read the name of the poet's friend W.H. and in this way it gives life to him. In this way the poet's friend's beauty will remain forever and forever through the poetry of poet. So as the beauty of his friend is portrayed in this poem, he has become the part of it. Therefore, so long as men live on earth and they have the eyes to see and read, the beauty of his friend will be read by them through the poem of Shakespeare. In this way, the beauty of his friend shall become the part of eternal things. Thank you for listening my presentation. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you.